Click the bell icon to get latest videos from Ekeeda.
Hello friends, now let us move on to the new topic, that is important compounds of calcium. Means we are going to talk about those compounds which consist of calcium as a main component. So now let us talk about it. So talking about the first compound that we are going to talk about, and that is calcium oxide, basically known as quicklime, or which have a molecular formula, that is CaO. So in this case, basically we are going to talk about that how can we prepare this quicklime, or how can we prepare calcium oxide along with the properties, as well as what are the uses of the quicklime, or what are the uses of the calcium oxide. So now let us move on with the first one, that is we are talking about calcium oxide, and let us understand what are the methods to prepare calcium oxide. So it is a very easy method to prepare calcium oxide. As we know, that is it could be prepared by CaCO3, basically known as calcium carbonate. So this CaCO3, which is basically, we could find it in chalk also. So what we have to do is we have to decompose it. So if we decompose it with a particular temperature, that is the temperature is been given as, that is 1270 Kelvin. So in that case, what happens is the calcium oxide has been formed along with that of the carbon dioxide has been liberated. So if we have measured, that is 1 gram of calcium carbonate, and if we have tried to decompose it, then most of the mass, it would be remain in the form of solid, while the rest of the mass, it would be evolved in the form of gas, that is carbon dioxide. So this is how we can prepare calcium oxide. But as I mentioned here also, that is it is a kind of a reversible reaction. Means suppose if we have to prepare CaO, then because of which the carbon dioxide is being liberated, and that is how we can obtain, that is quick lime. But the thing is, this reaction is reversible, means in the atmosphere basically the carbon dioxide is also been present, so therefore the carbon dioxide can again react with calcium oxide so as to form, that is CaCO3. So that is the reason we have to make sure that we are giving more than, that is 1270 Kelvin as a temperature, and then only we'll get, that is CaO, and that is known as quicklime. So this were related to the preparation of that is quicklime, and now let us move on to the next one, that is how can we describe the different properties of quicklime. So now let us understand that. So discussing about the properties of the calcium oxide, so let us understand the few physical properties, and those are, that is calcium oxide is white amorphous solid. As we know, that is calcium carbonate is also white, and on decomposition basically we could get that is calcium oxide, even that calcium oxide is also white in color, but the thing is it is amorphous solid. And now let us move on to the next one, that is it has a melting point of 2870 Kelvin. It has a higher melting point, and that is 2870 Kelvin. That's the reason they are present in a solid form, in a normal state also. And now let us move on to the next one, that is chemical properties. So the chemical properties, let us start with the first reaction, and so that we could even describe that what happens in this kind of reaction. So suppose if I am talking about the first reaction, that is whenever the calcium oxide is been treated with water, then we could get CaOH twice, which is basically known as slick lime. And in this case, basically 63 kilojoule of energy has been liberated through 1 mole of calcium oxide when it is dissolved in water. So this kind of reaction is basically exothermic reaction, and that's the reason that during formation of CaOH twice, whenever the calcium oxide has been dissolved in water, so the calcium oxide gets dissolved in water as well as it forms, that is CaOH twice. But this kind of method to prepare, that is CaOH twice, is basically known as slaking of lime. And this is what the first reaction is. And again, as I've told you earlier also, that is it is an exothermic reaction. So this was I was talking about. And now let us move on to the next property, that is what happens if calcium oxide is treated with carbon dioxide. So this is the reaction that we have did in our previous one, that is during the preparation of CaO from calcium carbonate. And as I've mentioned earlier also, that is it is a reversible reaction. So therefore the calcium oxide, whenever it reacts with carbon dioxide, it forms calcium carbonate. But again, as I've told you, that it is a reversible reaction, and that's the reason that is we could convert CaCO3 back into, that is calcium oxide. So this were the chemical properties, few of the chemical properties. But yes, there are more chemical properties that I want to talk about. So now let us move on to the next one. So the next property is about the acidity or basicity of calcium oxide. So quicklime is found to be, it is basic in nature. That's the reason quicklime is basic oxide. So it could be easily reacted with an acidic oxide also. So there are few reactions there in this case I have to mention about, and that is whenever the calcium oxide has been treated with, that is 2 moles of ammonium chloride, and on heating we could get, that is CaCl2, that is calcium chloride, along with that of the evolution of ammonia gas as well as water. So this is a kind of reaction that and again this is a kind of property that I was talking about the chemical properties. So even this is how we could prepare, that is calcium chloride. And now let us move on to the next one. That is, as we have mentioned earlier also, that is quicklime is basic oxide. So that is the reason it could easily react with the one which is acidic oxide. So that is the reason calcium oxide can easily react with, that is SiO2, basically silicon, silicon dioxide, and that's the reason that we could get the salt like CaSiO3. So this is something that we could get during a reaction of a basic oxide with that of an acidic oxide. So this was few of the chemical properties as well as few of the chemical preparation of different compounds that could be exhibited through, that is, calcium oxide. So this was something related to the physical property as well as the chemical property. But now let us move on to the next one, that is the uses of the calcium oxide. So the uses are, so the uses of the calcium oxide is as follows, and let us understand that one. That is, it is used to manufacture sodium carbonate. Sodium carbonate, that is Na2CO3, with the help of, that is, caustic soda, that is NaOH. So whenever we dissolve that is CaO in NaOH, we could get that is sodium carbonate, that is Na2CO3. So even there we could form, that is, sodium carbonate with the help of caustic soda as well as with the help of quicklime. And now let us move on to the further point, that is, it is an important primary material for large scale production of cement. Yes, nowadays cement, they include the main ingredient, and that is basically calcium oxide. And since it is a quicklime, so therefore quicklime easily reacts with water, as well as it could form the strength, it could give the strength to the cement, and that is how the cements are nowadays used widely. And so these are the uses of quicklime, and this is what I was talking about. So this was related to the first compound that I was talking about, which consists of calcium. And now let us move on to the next one, and that is calcium carbonate. So in this case also, we are going to talk about that, what are the different methods to prepare calcium carbonate, as well as what are the different properties that could be exhibited by calcium carbonate, as well as the uses of calcium carbonate. So now let us talk about the first one, that is, let us understand what is the preparation of calcium carbonate. So talking about the preparation, that is, whenever basically a slake lime, that is CaOH twice, or basically we would also call it as, that is, calcium hydroxide, is been treated with carbon dioxide, then the product that we could get is basically CaCO3 plus H2O. So this is what I have explained earlier only, but the thing is, this kind of reaction is what we have to take certain kind of precautions. Yes, suppose if we have that is, if we have added more amount of Ca2 during the formation of that is calcium carbonate from slake lime, then the thing is, the product that we could get would be basically soluble in nature, because we know that CaCO3 basically it is found in chalk, and the chalk is not soluble in water. So that's the reason. Now this CaCO3 is basically insoluble in water. So what happens if we add more amount of carbon dioxide during the preparation of CaCO3 in CaOH twice? So therefore it would give us a soluble salt, and that could be represented as, suppose if we have formed, that is, CaCO3 along with that of we have also got water as a byproduct, and suppose if these two are present in the solution, and suppose in excess amount we have added carbon dioxide, so in this case basically the product that we could get, it could be calcium bicarbonate. And this calcium bicarbonate is actually soluble in water. So since the calcium bicarbonate is soluble in water, so we can't predict whether we have formed calcium carbonate or not. So that's the reason we have to take certain kind of precautions, and we have to add only certain amount of carbon dioxide so as to get a perfect amount of that is calcium carbonate. So therefore these are also the precautions that we have to take. And now let us move on to the next one, and that is, so this was one of the method where we have prepared calcium carbonate. And now let us discuss about what are the different methods where we could form calcium carbonate, and that is because of calcium chloride. Yes, if we take calcium chloride and if we try to react it with, that is, sodium carbonate, and in this case basically we could get that is the reaction would happen in such a way, that is, we could obtain CaCO3 while the 2NaCl, it will be also been produced in the solution. And because NaCl is been basically soluble in water, so therefore the only thing that we could get in a solid form in the solution is basically CaCO3, or we could get in a form of precipitate. And this is how we could form, that is, CaCO3 with the help of calcium chloride also. So this were the certain kind of preparations that I was talking about for the preparation of CaCO3 or calcium carbonate. And now let us move on to the next one, that is what are the different properties that could be exhibited by calcium carbonate. So now let us discuss about that. So now we are going to discuss about the properties of the calcium carbonate, and those are as follows. So here we are going to talk about the physical properties as well as the chemical properties. So now let us discuss about this thing. So talking about calcium carbonate, it is actually a white fluffy powder which is insoluble in water. So this is what we have discussed earlier also. And calcium carbonate is very easy to get, because as I've mentioned earlier also, it is present in chalk as well as it can be present in marbles also. Those marbles that are being used as tiles in our home. So now let us move on to the chemical properties. So let us move on to the chemical properties, in which basically we are going to talk about what are the different kind of chemical reactions that could be exhibited by the calcium carbonate, and what are the different compounds that we could obtain from calcium carbonate. So talking about the first one, that is calcium carbonate on decomposition, as we have mentioned earlier also, that is we could get that is calcium oxide along with that of carbon dioxide. So in this case, we are also talking about that how can we prepare calcium oxide from calcium carbonate. So this was the first one that I was talking about, and now let us move on to the next one, that is CaCO3, that is calcium carbonate, can be easily reacted with the dilute mineral acids also, and those mineral acids are basically HCl and H2SO4. So what happens if calcium carbonate is been reacted with the mineral acid, or basically dilute mineral acid, that is HCl? So we could form that is CaCl2 along with that of water, and carbon dioxide is been evolved. So even this could be something which where we could prepare that is calcium calcium chloride, and this is what the second reaction is. And now let us move on to the next one, that is what happens if calcium carbonate is being treated with sulfuric acid, and in this case also it is a very dilute acid we have to take. So therefore calcium carbonate, if it reacts with sulfuric acid, we could obtain that is calcium sulfate along with that of water and carbon dioxide. So this were the few chemical properties that I have mentioned in this topic, and that's it. And now let us mention about the last one, that is what are the uses of the calcium carbonate. So those are, so talking about the uses of calcium carbonate, the first use is to prepare quicklime. So this is what we have did various times in this topic only. So now let us move on to the next one, that is the mixture of calcium carbonate and that is MgCO3, that is magnesium carbonate, is used as a flux in extraction of metals such as iron. So basically it is used as a main ingredient to remove the impurity and in the metallurgical process, where basically CaCO3 and MgCO3 are used as flux. So what happens is this flux actually it combines with the impurity basically known as gangues, and that is how basically a slag has been removed, and that is how we could purify or we could help in the purification of a particular metal that is to be extracted from the ore. So even that plays a very vital role. And it is basically used for iron, and that's the reason in blast furnace basically CaCO3 has been used. And now let us move on to the next one, and that is it is used in the manufacturing of high quality paper. Even the lumps of that is calcium carbonate, which are basically fluffy and powder form, so even that could be used to prepare a high quality paper, and that quality paper is basically made up of CaCO3 as a main ingredient, because it forms a white layer on it, and that's the reason that it loses its color while it has been applied on the paper or while during the preparation of the high quality paper. So that are the certain uses of the calcium carbonate that I have mentioned over here, and that's it. So in this topic basically we have covered about the two main compounds of calcium, that is calcium carbonate as well as quicklime, that is CaO, so and as well as the uses of it as well as the properties. So thank you friends for watching this video. I hope you have understood this video very clearly and you have got to know various information regarding this. So I hope you will share this video with your friends, and yes, don't forget to subscribe Ekeeda channel. Thank you so much.